strength, O Chosen. Of this world falls to the King of Kings. His providence consecrated in the divine light of the crystal. So it is ordained, the revelation of Bahamut. The heart of the crystal. The soul of the star. And it is in this place that the king will gain the power to fulfill his calling. They stand against the darkness and abide in hope. Sustained by faith unfaltering that their king shall arise and bring deliverance. By the covenants awakened, the six have seen the coming of the prophesied hour. A time when the crystal shall have shed the entirety of its light unto the ring. Only then, once the sacred ring is replete, can the true king complete his ascension. And only by the true king's hand can the immortal accursed be banished and the light restored to this world. It is the sole means to ending the immortal accursed. A power greater than even that of the six, purifying all by the light of the crystal and the glaives of rulers past. Only at the throne can the Chosen receive it, and only at the cost of a life his own. Eternal, whose immortality stems from the self-same scourge that wrought the demons. One so impure of body and soul was deemed unworthy of the crystal's light and forbidden to ascend. His mind twisted by spite and bent on revenge, the usurper came to bring darkness down upon our world. Only the true king, chosen by the crystal and guarded by his forebears, can end the accursed's madness. The King of Kings shall be granted the power to banish the darkness, but the blood price must be paid. To cast out the usurper and usher in dawn's light will cost the life of the Chosen. Sacrificed all for the king, so must the king sacrifice himself for all. Now enter into reflection, let the light of providence shine within. axe is full. Go forth to the kingdom where the usurper awaits. Reclaim the throne and fulfill the calling of the true king.